Hey guys, so today I created this look with the Morphe Jaclyn Hill Vault Collection, and today I used the Purple Bling Boss palette. This palette is from the second release of the Vault Collection, so if you want to see how I got this look and my opinions on this palette, go ahead and keep on watching. I'm so freaking ready for this video. I'm so excited, you guys don't even know. We are filming with the Jaclyn Hill Vault Collection. Again, I just got the re-release of the Vault Collection in the mail, so I'm ready to film and use these palettes, and hopefully they are better than the first round of these palettes. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, go ahead and Google like Morphe Vault Collection re-release or something like that. You'll find YouTube videos explaining what happened with these palettes and why they decided to take the palette back and relaunch it later on. I'm not gonna go into depth about this drama because I'm not a drama channel. I'm focusing on the makeup and how the palettes actually work and if the palettes work better than the first launch of these palettes. When the collection first launched in June, I did 4 videos using these palettes. So if you wanna see my thoughts on the original palettes that came out, I will link those up above for you. So I did 1 tutorial using each colored palette, so check those out if you want to see my first opinions and like which palettes I had were good and bad. So I'm going to do the same types of videos I did last June. So every single day this week, starting today, Monday, going till Friday, I'll have a video up using one of the palettes from the Vault Collection. I'll do one with each color, and then my last video on Friday will be a look using all 4 palettes together. In my first video with these palettes, I did do swatches comparing them to the shades in the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm not going to do that again just because that seems really repetitive because the shades are exactly the same. You guys want a quick reminder, it was the Bling Boss palette, which is the purple one here, that gave me the most troubles. Specifically the shade Sparks and Rockstar, they were so patchy, did not blend for me, and it was just awful. I know a lot of people were and are excited about this purple palette, so that's what we're doing first. And today I'm gonna use the new version of the palette on my eye, and I'm just gonna tell you kind of how it compares to the first version. I marked my first release palettes with a number 1, so I know which palettes are what, and so I don't get a mixed up because that would suck if I got it mixed up. I think that's everything I need to say right now, so let's get into the tutorial using the Bling Boss palette. I'm really nervous. All right, I'm just gonna go in with the shades. So I'm gonna take Sparks on a Sigma E25. I have that much on my brush and I tapped off the excess, and we're just gonna put this in my crease and pray to God it blends. I think in my case with these palettes, I struggled the most with this shade out of all of them, but this is blending. Oh my goodness! Taking more on my brush, and I'm just gonna build it up. You could do patting motions if you want more of an intense color, but I'm doing more swiping motions so it blends it out. Oh, and for the videos I'm doing with the Vault Collection, I made 2 different playlists on my channel. So you'll see one that says like round 1 and round 2. Round 2 means the new collection, just in case you're wondering. So I'm very, very happy that the shade is blending a million times better than the first time. I'm gonna take the shade Hush Hush, and I'm gonna go around the edges of Spark to help blend it out. Now I'm gonna bring Sparks on my lower lash line. I'm gonna take a Sigma E34 in the shade Rockstar, and I'm gonna use this to deepen up the crease. And this shade gave me a lot of problems in the first release as well. Then I'm gonna pack a little bit more on my outer corner. This shade is beautiful. All right, now I'm gonna take my E25 and just blend. So this is exactly how I expect Morphe eyeshadows to work, and I'm so happy they're working! Yay! I'm also gonna bring Rockstar on my lower lash line. And then I'm just gonna blend. I'm gonna bring a little bit more Sparks kind of on the upper part of my lid, just to help blend the purple into the eye a little bit more. Alright, now I'm gonna take Mystic, and I'm just gonna tap that in my crease as well to deepen it up even more. Then I'm gonna bring a little bit of Mystic right out here on the outer part of my lower lash line. And I'm just gonna say too, I have a tiny bit of fallout, but nothing to complain about. Especially when using dark purple shades like this, that's really surprising. I'm gonna take Ballsy on my finger. You see like where this blank part of my lid is? I'm just gonna pack the shade right in that area and then just kind of blend it out with my finger. Oh my gosh. This is seriously so stunning. It's like a lavender, like with hints of yellowy gold in it. I'm gonna take Bling Bling on a L04 and put that in my inner corner. And a little right under my brow bone. All right, now I'm gonna pop on some mascara and lashes and I will be right back. All right, so I put the Urban Decay eyeliner in Alkaline in my waterline. And for lashes, I used Lily Lashes Mink Ella. And here's the final look. I am so freaking happy that this palette worked, oh my god. I love the look I created, the shades went really well together and they all blended amazing. This is the type of quality that I expect from Morphe and I'm happy we finally got it. So make sure to stay tuned the rest of this week for more videos with the Vault Collection and I'll try out every single palette and tell you how it is and if it was better than the first launch. This one gets an A+ for me, so I'm very, very happy it worked out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, thank you so much for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe.